Here we go again. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Today, we're going to have a rough over of blower motors. Somebody sent me some inquiring questions about their blower motor. So we're just going to go over a couple of different designs here real quick. And hopefully I can help them out. And our first step is to distinguish what type of blower motor we have. Oh, oh no! This example here is probably the most standard. It has a belly band that tightens with that nut, and it has connecting feet that bolt to the housing. And of course then there's a skull cage, and the skull cage is set by a lock. There are several different types of belly bands, but usually they vary by what size the motor is and how they mount, which that one is not really adjustable. It just tightens on here, and then it has rubber grommets that mount to the housing. And again, here's another type of belly band. Adjustable universal belly bands usually come with a set of feet, depending on the application. They're usually not included with the motor, but in case you needed to adapt the motor to a unit, you'd need a belly band kit. Now another type of motor would be a direct mount. These actually have screws that go into the side, so there's no belly band. That actually screws right into the side of the motor. Here's another example inside the housing. These are usually Conquest 80. Here we've got extra brackets because they have a tendency to crack over time. But you can put some Zilver tape on it. Now another type is a belt driven. These actually have a mounting bracket that screws onto the side of the housing. And they're adjustable by this bolt here. So you tighten the bolt up and it comes up. You let the bolt down, it goes down. And that's how you adjust the tension on your belt. But those two, these are cradle mount, and you just take these screws off here, and that'll pop right off. Now these type here are probably the toughest of the tough. These are dual scroll cage. That's actually a double shafted motor. So that motor has a shaft coming out of both sides. There's another example, and they're a little bit more complex to change. You have to disassemble both scroll cages. And here's another belt driven motor. It's a little bigger. And there is another foot mount type. That's direct mount. So as you can see, there's all different types. And usually when I tear a furnace out, like the one first pictured, we usually pull the blower out, and that'll get us by in a bind in the middle of the night. So we never let a customer without heat. Blower motors are all different, and it's impossible to stock every one of them on your truck. Most of them are universal, but in a pinch, we just slide it right out and slide in one of ours to get them through the night, and then we order a motor, and we get them all fired up. All right, here's an example of two sample replacement blower motors. These are for carriers, and I have them side by side here just so you can see the difference. Okay, this is a motor, indoor, quarter horsepower, 115 volt. That's your capacitor size. That's the RPMs, and that's the number of speeds. Okay, counterclockwise lead end. This wouldn't be a reversible motor. All right, it's a half inch shaft by 3.9 quarter inches long. Now this one is a motor, indoor, quarter horsepower, 230 volt, 7.5 370 capacitor, 1075, half inch shaft, 2.5 inches long, clockwise lead end. So they're basically pretty much the same motor. This one's going in an opposite direction than this one, and this one's 230 volt, and this one's 115 volt. So this one would be more for a furnace, this one would be more for a heat pump. Or other air handler, that would be 230 volt. Alright, so you just gotta make sure you know what you're buying. Make sure you get the right one. And so this concludes our tour of blower motors. I hope you learned as much as I've tried to demonstrate. But if you have any other questions, just give me a holler. I'll be more than happy to assist you.